there, Prestonwood kids. My name is Connor Bales, and I serve as the lead pastor for the North Campus of Prestonwood Baptist Church, and I'm looking very forward to answering some of the great questions that you guys have asked as together we learn more about God. Because Jesus is God, who came to earth as a man, he has never been created, but he has always existed. If God had been created, then there would have had to have been someone or something else that created him. God is underneath everything, he is before everything, and he is over everything. This is what the Bible would say in Colossians. What makes the Bible so special is that it was written down by human authors, but God is the one who gave them the thoughts in their mind and gave them the feelings in their heart that would guide how they were going to write down all of the history and the story and the great narratives that tell of God's love for us. The Bible was written down by more than 40 different authors. It's written in 3 different languages, and it's written over a timeline of more than 1,500 years. And what's amazing? It tells one story. It tells God's love story for you and me, that he loves us so much he sent Jesus for us, so that when we trust in him, we can be forgiven of our sin and have life with God forever. Who has the longest beard in the Bible? Surely it would have to have been Jeremiah the prophet. No, it had to have been Moses or the Apostle Paul, who wrote so much of the New Testament. Maybe it was Noah. Maybe it was John the Baptist, who had locusts and honey in his beard. I bet it was super gross. Actually, the Bible doesn't answer the question as to who has the longest beard, but it's a lot of fun to think about. Everybody is called by God to go and to tell the good news. Jesus said in the last conversation that he had on earth, in Matthew chapter 28, he said, "Go and make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teach them to observe all that I commanded you." And then he promised us, whatever you do in your classroom at school, on your sports team, with your parents at home, or your neighbors at the park, I will be with you always, to the end of the age. And this promise of Jesus was not given only to pastors or only to ministers. It was given to the church, to all of us, that we should go and make disciples. And so it's important for me to do, and it's important for you to do as well.